Hi, my name is Beng Poka. Today I'm presenting the last masterpiece. It's the first 2.5 meter. The whole painting will be 10 meters. And it's part 2 out of History Foundation. Part 1 out of History Foundation is the history of the world from beginning to the year zero. Before the year zero, our world had been living a history, a global civilization that was mostly highest in Africa. It was in Mexico, all over the world, there had been a global civilization. There had the calendar, the horoscope, everything that we know today. They have enjoyed the civilization, but it was based on truth and knowledge. Magic was the higher sense. So that civilization, we don't really know what's happened to them, why there has been an end to that civilization. But through the cycle of life, we know life and death, the beginning and the end, is an inescapable process in our universe. Today is Art of History Foundation Part 2. Art of History Foundation Part 2 is about the European civilization that has been the most highlight civilization from century, where the earth have been reconquered to the year zero, the year of Jesus, and we have the Big Bang. The universe have been redesigned, because the universe have been designed before, but the universe have been redesigned with the Big Bang, the dark matter, the atom, and all the research people have been finding and adding, how the universe is expanding, how the universe come out of nothing and suddenly there was a bang. All those theory people have been imagining and adding to the history of this civilization. Today, meaning in the year 2000, our world started entering another civilization took over. So we are living the brink, the collapsing, the there is a war about the extension of this civilization that is holding on, is gone, not collapse, because everything is written in the sky. It's up to us to describe what is written. And mostly this civilization based on higher religion and scientists have been mostly based on lies, not on truth. And with the globalization, because things are going towards what was before. Because in every continent we saw the pyramid and the artifact, the writing, the similarity of what was before. Then when we start our civilization in year zero, from year zero to date, humans have been more focused in war, destruction, slavery, colonization, democracy, everything is just war and war and war, and lies, politics, everything has been just chaotic for humanity to live in peace and dwelling. But with the new civilization taking place, we can see how humans are coming more into light, coming more into having their life back, knowing what really happened. Politicians are less capable to be unnoticed Of course, the population is still being manipulated, but it's not like it used to be. People are more aware. And this is due to the collapse of a civilization, because one thing they're collapsing, people becoming more aware. And we have more wealthiest country today all over the world. And things are set to make sure this kind of thinking of one man doing everything will not happen anymore in our world. It's not going to be that if one person said the world started by Big Bang or the evolution so that the whole Earth will believe in the same thing. No, ideas will be shaped in every human being as it can understand and it can live by them. That is the era of globalization, where one person will never know anymore everything and imposing his system of domination on other. This time where we are in is very critical, because so many life and so many human will lose their life because of the determination of the old civilization not to collapse. But the evidence is it has already collapsed, because other have taken place and they are establishing themselves just like the year zero. Everything was already gone from the old civilization, the Pharaoh and all the other, they passed away. We don't know what has happened, but that has end up the civilization of the pyramid all over the world. Now this civilization will start with Rome going all over the world, Spain, France, England having the dominion through war and invasion. All that belong to the past today. Although war, and they still carrying the same thing, because it's not easy to bring change, because even in individual life, when a person is not aware of the change around him, it can carry on with the old mentality in the new, in the change is being into. And most of human live life that way. You can see somebody who yesterday was nothing, one day he become a millionaire, but seeing him carrying on the old mentality of people, the old mentality he used to live, he used to have in the new place where he is. That is what's happening to us today, where the computer does not choose. You can buy something online, you don't know who's selling that to you. But if in your mind you don't like certain people, you'll be buying for them, not knowing you're buying for them, because computer and tools we use does not discriminate. But we are trying to enter the new world with our old mentality. We are trying to change the world by not changing the philosophy and things who are so much into us, like the evolution theory. It's still so much into human blood, Big Bang theory, the religion that brings discrimination. So only by looking at the religion era, where you have the Muslim, we are 1 billion and something, the Christian and the Buddhist and all the other denomination, is it does not match the actual world we live in. But people just need to open their eyes, because if you want to see as well in the meantime, the history of human discrimination, where one is called black meaning bad, you call a human bad, when something wrong somewhere, you said this has been a bad day, this has been a dark day. So those things are into human inner mechanism, but they don't belong anymore to the world we are living today, because the world we are living today is the world of exchange, is the world of sharing. Every country you will go, you will see human from everywhere. It's not like it used to be, meaning Africa for African, Europe from European, or this part for those people. The sick are there, the trap is there, that trap doesn't make, that trap. No, that belongs to the past. Today, you see human everywhere at any time. So the description like a British citizen or a British national or a black British or other or thing, those things will completely disappear because people will come back to knowledge to understand that a land, a country doesn't belong to some people. A country is part of the world and it wasn't made with barrier. That is the kind of world we are going into. But it's just, it's still a bit difficult for us to let go what have been shaping us for so long. But if our children and the children of our children will never bear our mind, they cannot live in our mind and sharing that kind of world which is designing himself. Just look how things are moving. Just look around any house. You will see things manufactured in China, things look at here, the banana. Are they more in Europe? No, banana are in Europe everywhere. That means food are moving, flour, everything is moving, but human, they still having the mindset into the past. They do not understand which kind of world we are in today. We are into another era. And that era has a leader. And that leader does not walk through war. It doesn't destroy order. So all those philosophies we are sharing today, we are living by today, are meant to disappear. Just like in the first 10 meter painting out of history foundation that was highly in Africa, the scientists were not called scientists. They were mystic, they were magical. When in the Bible you see in Egypt, when God sent Moses, the Pharaoh didn't send a scientist, he sent a magician. But today, those magicians have been changed to scientists. The world of today use scientists for reference for everything. But tomorrow, I don't think scientists will have that power because there is a lot of bad science and they have to change science time to time. Because tomorrow is the world of truth. So the world, the out of history part three, is going to be knowledge that will be the high praise people, people of love. Because knowledge is equal to love, and love is equal to eternity. And all those things are making the time. Because in time, everything is revealed. So the world we are entering today is the world of knowledge. And with knowledge, ignorance disappears. And light shine more among humans. Although for me, the best place is the darkness. Because it's where everything lives in peace. And it's where everything derives from. And go back to. Thank you for watching. I'm going to carry on pushing the painting. Don't stop following. I know it's difficult for us to take all those things today because we are not yet there, but it's amazing to discover other thing that we are not used to. It's amazing to discover how other human think and what they have in their pocket. Thank you very much.